we started talking about, what are we going to do if we can't have that first showing? What are we going to do if we can't have that first, you know, we want to sell our houses quickly. How can we get it done? And I started Googling different cameras and products, and I came across the Matterport virtual tours, and we made the investment, and it's been a really good way for me to combine my two passions. It was difficult to learn the camera at first, and I would say even still I'm kind of struggling with the getting used to all the new features, because as the world continues to grow and adapt to what's going on, Matterport's constantly changing their back office. So just when you think you have it down, it changes again. And so, yeah.
And so once you figured it out, is it pretty easy to just put in a room? Like, it kind of...
Yeah. So what you do is you move the camera every 4 to 6 feet throughout the house. And I think it's really... I have buyers in New Hampshire, New York, North Carolina, Florida, and we've really connected over social media. And this Matterport has been a great way to show them kind of their first view of the house without actually having to fly to Massachusetts in a time that you really can't. So it's really, you see, if you were to look on the Matterport system, every 4 to 6 feet, you'll see a little circle on the floor and you can click it and spin and see a full 360 view of the house. And you can measure with a tool on there and see what size bed they have. And it gives you a fully generated floor plan. And it's really helped in a time where people are not allowed to come to a different state or maybe are uncomfortable leaving their homes, that now they can kind of shop for homes without really even leaving where they are.
Yeah. Have you seen any of your clients buy a house sight unseen just through Matterport or something like that?
I have had clients put in an offer subject to being able to get there and see the home. But we have had people submitting offers, and it's, the market has just been so crazy that so many people are trying to get out of the city and coming from really those more overpopulated areas, that you almost have to do something like that. You almost have to put in an offer sometimes, because there's such a little inventory and so many buyers.
If you can't take a picture, and you know you can't take a picture, it just is in your best interest to hire somebody. And then when you're going on your next listing appointment, you can show them what you produce for marketing. Because that's really what separates real estate agents, when you're especially a listing agent, from another listing agent, is the marketing. Mm. And the marketing starts with the photography, because that's the first thing someone's going to see online, are the pictures. And sellers are asking to see your pictures, mm-hmm. because they know, because they're on looking anyway. They were looking for houses before they even thought about putting their house on the market. And then they're like, well, you know, we can move here. Let's get our house on the market. Sellers already know they want good pictures. So if you know you don't take good pictures, it's not that expensive.
And that would be something that the agent or the agency or the brokerage, they're the ones that pay for it, right?
It's all different. I've shot for agents where the seller paid me directly. A lot of times the agent pays. Normally the agent is an independent contractor. Mm-hmm. So they'll pay it. They can write it off as an advertising expense. Sometimes if they're part of a group, the group will pay for it. It's all different. There's really no one answer. Whatever gets you to click on the listing is cool. And sometimes those 360 things are really interesting. But it all depends. It's not a one size fits all. If you have really small rooms, let's say you have an old Cape house, which we have lots of old Cape houses and old colonial houses in Rhode Island, and you've got a 360 camera in the middle of a really small family room, it's just wall, window, wall. You don't really get a feel for it. If it's the right tool for the job, great. I have no problem with that. But don't just use it because it's a tool that's available. I personally don't use that, because my way of showing how a house and a room and a scenario is warm and inviting is with the photography. Mm-hmm. I also do video, so I can do something as simple as string photos together into a video, or take panning video. There's so many different things. I hate to see people waste money, mm-hmm. and time. It can be a cool tool in the right situation.
Makes sense, yeah.
And remember, people are looking at properties on their phones. Right. So, they have to have a little bit of patience to scroll through a property, with their fingertips. In the right situation, okay, cool. But not every situation.